It's time to rip and tear. Let's take this little thing apart.
Wicked Gamer and Collector!
Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. And in today's video, we are going to do a little bit of a rip and tear. I want to see what's inside the K9. We have did a review about it. And if you missed it out, don't forget to check it out. And yeah, I want to know what's inside this. So, stay tuned. Grab yourself a cup of coffee. Or a cup of tea, what do you want, what do you prefer? And let's open it up. All right, people, let's open it up. Oh no, I didn't remove this one. It was missing when making this review. Oh yeah, quality control, quality control.
All right, I'm going to remove the four screws. This is a very easy thing to do. It's now high engineering. I'm guessing this thing is basically the same like the K8 I've reviewed and also did a teardown of. I'm very curious, is this one looking similar like the other version? The shell itself looks similar, only this one doesn't have this dust cover because there is no cartridge. Alright. The front board looks the same, but of course the main board itself is different because, yeah, we don't have a cartridge and we have HDMI out. So alright, let's do a little bit of a closer view. What are we going to get?
So people, this is what we're going to get. It's a pretty damn basic system. I'm going to do a little bit of an overview and I tried to search the information on the internet. Maybe I didn't search good enough, but if you have some information, you can always leave it in the comments. So let's start this little tour. All right, at the front side, we're finding the PCB, and this one is for connecting the game ports to the main board. I see a little date here. I'm going to zoom in. So it seems to be that this one is from 2018. And I'm guessing this is the month and the day, so this is the 7th month of 2018 that this PCB was produced. By the way, I just bought it in 2019 when making this video. The first thing that I'm noticing on this mainboard that we're having here, the option for a cartridge slot or something that you can solder on this PCB board. If you have seen my previous video, the K8 was one with AV out, but has a little slot. So you can put this cartridge in that contains the games. So it's not on this one, but it seems to be there is something with this mainboard that's still option for it. What you can see here, I hope you can read it on the camera. This is the chip that converts AV signal, or if you read this and try to search on the internet, this is more for an AV to HDMI converter. So this chip makes the AV old school signal going to the HDMI. So this is the built-in converter. A really funny fact, I have noticed that if you look at the mainboard, it says here SNES. So I am guessing they already, this is just a reuse of the mainboard. I'm guessing this one is or can be found in the SNES Mini clones that I reviewed before. So it's basically the same date. No, it's more like 2018, but it's another month. And here we have this black blob, and this is for protection that the competition cannot basically copy their information on it. I'm guessing this is more like the information where the ROMs and the emulation and the menu, everything is hidden. So I did try to search more information about the components, but I couldn't find any information. So this is more like the overview of the main board. All right, people, for the final conclusion, this is what we're going to get. It seems to be that they even reusing this main board that they, I guess they use it for a SNES clone or something. So this is what you're going to get. If you have seen some info or you have seen a familiar chip, let me know in the comments. So this is what we're going to get. I especially made this video for you. I really love this teardown videos. So yeah, the conclusion video. Don't forget to like, don't forget to subscribe, hit the little bell, and if you're into gaming, check out the gaming channel. See you next time. Bye-bye.